I want to talk about literature as a historical source. Historical studies help us reflect and critically consider the dimensions that have shaped us and continue to shape our understanding of our world. There are a wide variety of competing sources that draw and pull on our attention and want to be heard. One of these is literature, which provides us with a ready source of historical interpretations. From a young age, our ideas of our past may have been shaped by what we've read or was read to us. For example, the tales of chivalry in Robin Hood and Arthurian legends. The novels of Charles Dickens, A Christmas Carol or Oliver Twist are another good example, as they provide us with vivid images of class, destitution and the workhouse in mid-Victorian England. Arguably, these are a version, an interpretation of the anxieties of an era mediated by the author, but images that could be formative in our understanding of the working class and poverty in mid-Victorian Britain. To develop this further, I want to consider one particular novel in detail, Dracula. Not a novel that you might readily associate with historical investigation, but it is one that I have used in my research. Published in 1897 by the enigmatic Irishman Bram Stoker, its angst-ridden narrative encompasses many of the prevalent fears, which included fears of loss of empire, immigration, loss of British identity, the rise of the new woman, political unrest, instability, and homosexuality. The novel focuses on the activities of the vampiric Count Dracula and his resettlement from Transylvania to London and his adversaries' attempts to stop him. On one level, the story is about vampires and those who battle against them. But if we consider the novel more deeply, we can see much more. By asking questions about the novel and interrogating the narrative, for example, about the locations and behaviour of the characters, we can learn more. We could question the significance of placing the vampire in London at that period. Why would Dracula want to move there? In his own words, he says, "I long to go through the crowded streets of your mighty London, to be in the midst of the whirl and rush of humanity, to share its life, its changes, its death, and all that makes it what it is." An innocent enough statement, you might think. But later, he adds that he might, amongst its teeming millions, satiate his lust for blood and create a new and ever-widening circle of semi-demons to batten on to the helpless. Who are the helpless? Who might batten on to them? Is the use of blood important? Is the location of London significant? These are all questions we might want to consider. In the late Victorian era, London was at the heart of the empire and seat of power and wealth. But this was under threat, both from troubles in the colonies and issues at home, causing uncertainty and apprehension. Stoker's novel reflects this by using London as an ideal location for a vampiric immigrant aristocrat from Eastern Europe who wants to turn its residents into vampires. Academics have wrestled with these questions and many more about Dracula for some time. Key areas they have considered include ideas based on Freudian or psychoanalytical, feminist, capitalist, Marxist, gender and sexuality, colonialist and orientalist approaches. These studies give different interpretations of the same novel, a novel which we might have felt we were familiar with. And although different, they do not necessarily contradict each other, but offer a plurality of interpretation of the same novel. Now, this might sound confusing. So, whose version is the right one? Well, all of the readings are right, as they are interpretations based on different belief structures. For example, if an academic looks at Dracula from a feminist point of view, they might think about how women are portrayed within the novel, and this can tell us something about women's lives in the time the book was written. But we may also want to use other approaches at the same time, overlapping them. When we read Dracula, it is the work of the author Bram Stoker. It has been written in a context which relates to him and the time in which he lived. When historians critically consider and unpick the novel, they can uncover history, as the characters provide vibrant interpretations of Victorian England, ones which give meaning and understanding to the novel and to the period in which it was conceived.